ब्रह्मादिभ्यो ब्रह्म विद्या संप्रदाय कर्तृभ्यो वंशर्षभ्यो महद्भ्यो नमो गुरुभ्यः सर्वोपप्लवरहित प्रज्ञान गण प्रत्यगर्थो ब्रह्माहमस्मि सोहमस्मि ब्रह्माहमस्मि। ओम प्रपन्न पारिजाताय तोत्र वेत्रैकपाणये ज्ञान मुद्राय कृष्णाय गीतामृतदुहे नमः। ओम नमो वेंकटेशाय। माय बेस्ट विशेस एंड परिपूर्ण आशीर्वादम्स टू ऑल द व्यूअर्स ऑफ श्री वेंकटेश्वर भक्ति चैनल। मे द ऑल माइटी श्री लॉर्ड वेंकटेश्वर बेस्टो ऑल काइंड्स ऑफ प्रॉस्पेरिटी हेल्थ वेल्थ एंड इटर्नल हैप्पीनेस विद परिपूर्ण लक्ष्मी कटाक्षम्स टू यू एंड योर एंटायर फैमिली मेंबर्स एंड फ्रेंड्स। As we began to see the summary of the fourth chapter, I introduced the first 15 chapter discuss about the difference between normal birth and the birth of Ishvara. And the main difference is karma phala and there is no karma phala. The normal birth is caused by karma phala because the jivas, we are endowed with ignorance. This is a shastric language. Sometimes, you know, mind is deviated from the shastric language, Vedic language, when we bring maya, karma phala, papa and punya. So normally this era people, the present people, they are not attracted by these words. They are attracted by the Westerner technical terms. But that's their personal life, we don't say anything, but these words, you have to have the patience when you hear. Avatara is the word. It is given only in our Sanatana Dharma. In all other dharmas, they speak only Devaduta, okay, messenger of the God. Here, there is no messenger of the God. Here it is said, as the God itself, he comes down. The normal birth is equal to falling down into the well. Because karma phalas, they pull us towards birth and death. Once you are born, you are pulled towards death. Once you achieve death, you are again pulled to birth. So it's going down to birth and death. It's like a falling into the well. But Bhagavan birth is not falling down. It is like, you know, coming down in order to rescue the jivas, coming to their level. A person, one who comes down in the well, goes down into the well in order to rescue the jivas, in order to rescue the sufferer. That's what we saw, the main difference between two births. A normal birth, which is caused by karma phala, the karma phala is because of karma, karma is because of ignorance. Ignorance means what? Ignorance means, so one who is not aware about himself. That self-realization was lacking. Because of the self-realization missing, the karma phala comes. In detail, he has given the explanation. Then God's birth, which is known as Divyam Janma, Divyam Karma. So he also comes as the blood and flesh human being, like Lord Ram, who has become as a human being alone. For the other people who lived with Ram, so many people, even they didn't know the secret of birth of Rama. Even Dasharatha, he was not aware. Therefore, he was crying when Rama departed to forest. So being a father of a God who is nothing but avatar, if he would have known that, he would have not worried. That's what Dhritarashtra's karma phala is. But Lakshmana, who was with him having devotion, even Bharata, who was with him having lots of devotion, so Bharata and Lakshmana both had a value, a respect and affection, love and bhakti towards this Lord Rama. So whether they understood or not, Bhagavan Rama is an avatara. No. Therefore, this avatara, there are two kinds. So one is for the teaching. Another is like example. So Rama's life is an example to the society. Krishna's life, the teaching which he has given, that is the boon for society. So that's what the way of life. The birth differs, though we are not able to understand, but the avatara's purpose, in order to establish dharma, in order to uplift dharma, in order to slay the adharma, and the inner spark, the inner core of the avatara, he continues as muktatma, free, liberated, muktaha. But we continue as a baddhaha. Baddha means the bound people who is endowed with bondage. Bondage means what? Suffering. And this suffering may differ person to person, but the incarnation, who has been incarnated himself, swamayaya, by his own sankalpa. Therefore, this concept of avatara, you need to have a different perception to understand it. Because normally it is not spoken anywhere else. If anybody talks about avatara, we consider these people are, you know, impractical people. How can you say so? You have to study further. You should have the guru. You have to study so many things. If you have the knowledge from Puranas, if you go under these itihasas, you will come to know the avatara concept, what it is. Avatara can be in any form, as the protector, as the sustainer, as the destroyer. That's what avatara. Avatara does magic, is mystic, but when you surrender to them, he becomes the author, protector to you. He says, Ma Shushaha Sarva Dharman Parityajya Mamekam Sharanam Vijaya. How confident when he, Krishna, when he reveals the words. The delivery itself, you need to have the courage to see, courage to say it. So avatara means the purpose and the cause is karuna, compassion. Compassion towards jiva who are suffering by their own karma phala. They need to have some boat in order to cross the ocean called samsara. For that, these avataras are taking place. And the avatar of Rama being an example, dharma purushaha. And avatar of Krishna as an acharya, great acharya, no science can beat his teaching. Every word in Bhagavad Gita, you could see, they are valuable. So once you complete Bhagavad Gita, if you go through again you will get more deeper meaning, your buddhi will work like that. That's what the magic of Lord Krishna. And when they live, the purpose is to protect all the creatures, to uplift all of them. This is what the purpose of avatara and the lifestyle. And even, you know, Narasimha, he looks, you know, annoyed one, and who looks aggressive, but it's also compassion towards Prahlada. It's a compassion. This is a beautiful concept to realize, which was discussed from verse number 1 to 15. From 16 onwards up to 24th verse, he gives the secret of karma, the secret of the formula which is known as Buddhi Yoga. There alone we see the words karmanyah karmayah pasyet akarmanicha karmayah sabuddhiman manushyesho sayuktah krishna karma krito. Because the avatara God himself says, I don't have any karma phala, I am mukta purusha. You can also come up to my level. You can also find yourself equal to me if you follow this formula. So when you get the ability to see akarma in the karma, which we discussed in very detailed way, so seeing akarma in the karma means seeing Brahman in the Srishti. Seeing Brahman everywhere, identifying yourself with Brahman, you become one with all the difference. The creation happened only through Ishvara. The creation remains as Ishvara. It goes into Ishvara. What exists is nothing but Ishvara. That's what the perception, that's what the formula which was introduced in the verse number, I think 17 or 18. And this concept was taught elaborate way. What is akarma? What is karma? What is vikarma? So all this analysis about karma, deep analysis about karma, nowhere you find this kind of analysis. So this analysis must be read again and again, again and again, because that is what the life is. So our life is full of karma. So if you perform karma with this formula, if you are sticking with Brahman, definitely you will also become Mukta Purushaha. Then finally he concluded with Jnana Yajna from verse number 25th onwards to end of the chapter. He introduced 12 kinds of Yajna, beginning with Brahma Jnana Yajna, then Deva Yajna, then he started Vishaya Grahana Yajna, Vishaya Samyama, Indriya Samyama Yajna, and Atma Samyama Yajna, Dravya Yajna, Tapo Yajna, Yoga Yajna, then he Swadhyaya Yajna, then finally he concluded with Prana Yajna. So all these yajnas are practiced in various level, in various paths. So all these yajnas were introduced elaborately in nice way. And he also divided these 12 yajnas into two categories, Dravya Yajna, Jnana Yajna. Jnana Yajna means nothing but the realization of the self. Vedanta Shravana Manana Nididhyasanam, to listen to a guru, to listen to a shastra, to study shastra, to analyze the shastra, to inquire the shastra, and finally to meditate, to become one with the knowledge which is observed from the shastra. That is known as a great yajna. All yajnas are the means for, are means to get the maturity for these yajnas. So finally he concluded with the prayojana, with talking that every person has the rights to get, achieve the supreme knowledge. Finally he concluded, Shraddhavan labhate jnanam. A person, one who has the faith, definitely he will get it. So this is the content, the essence of the fourth chapter. So this fourth chapter is the main chapter where we find the topic of avatara, topic of Brahma Jnana Yajna. In the fourth chapter alone, you can learn the formula how to get rid of karma phala. Still you can continue in Grihasthashrama as the householder, being inner sannyasi. Is a beautiful chapter which was completed by the grace of Lord Krishna alone. We are entering now into fifth chapter. Let us begin with the first verse. Arjuna Uvacha Sanyasam Karmanam Krishna Punaryogam cha samshasin yachreya yetayor ekam tanme brohe sunishchitam. Now in the fourth chapter, Krishna spoke about inner sannyasa, being a householder. You can give up the karma phala, but you can continue with karma. So that's the formula. When you learn about sannyasa, the inner sannyasa, to be observed first. Then outer sannyasa, it may or may not be in your life if possible, but inner sannyasa is the supreme one. After describing about inner sannyasa, now the topic comes about outer sannyasa. ಸೊ ಔಟರ್ ಸನ್ಯಾಸ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಬಾಹ್ಯ ಸನ್ಯಾಸ, ಆರ್ ಕರ್ಮ ಸನ್ಯಾಸ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಡ್ರಾಪಿಂಗ್ ಆಲ್ ದ ಡ್ಯೂಟೀಸ್. ದಿಸ್ ಡ್ರಾಪಿಂಗ್ ಆಲ್ ದ ಡ್ಯೂಟೀಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ವಾಸ್ ಮೇಡ್ ಅ ಡಿಸಿಷನ್ ಬೈ ಅರ್ಜುನ, ಬಟ್ ಕೃಷ್ಣ ಡಿನೈಡ್, ಯು ಆರ್ ನಾಟ್ ಎಲಿಜಿಬಲ್ ಫಾರ್ ದಟ್. ನಾ he has given the core of how to become inner sannyasi. Now he has the duty to explain what is bahya means karma sannyasa is. Therefore he is beginning with Arjuna vacha, the question from Arjuna, because Vyasa, whenever he wants to create our mentality to make us to in a proper appropriate mentality, a state of mind, he is bringing that. So Vyasa, in order to make us to set a proper mentality for the subject matter, he brings a question from Arjuna. Arjuna uvacha, Arjuna said, karmanam sanyasam krishna punaha yogam sa samshasi. You prize both. You talk about the giving up karma phala, and you also talk about sannyasa, you prize both. So in between these two, which is the supreme one, please let me know. In simple way, you are talking about karma sannyasa, and you are talking about even inner sannyasa, karma phala tyagaha. So what is the difference in between these two? Bhagavan comes, Shri Bhagavan Uvacha, ಸನ್ಯಾಸ ಕರ್ಮ ಯೋಗಶ್ಚ ನಿಶ್ರೇಯಸ ಕರಾವುಭೌ ತಯೋಸ್ತ ಕರ್ಮ ಸನ್ಯಾಸಾತ್ ಕರ್ಮಯೋಗೋ ವಿಶೇಷ್ಯತೆ. ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಅವರ್ ದ ಟೀಚಿಂಗ್ ಆಫ್ ಸನಾತನ ಧರ್ಮ. ಇನ್ ಇಂಡಿಯಾ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಥಾಟ್ ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಸನ್ಯಾಸ. ದಟ್ಸ್ ಯೋರ್ ಪರ್ಸನಲ್ ಚಾಯ್ಸ್ ಟು ಬಿಕಮ್ ಸನ್ಯಾಸಿ ಆರ್ ಟು ಬಿಕಮ್ ನಾನ್ ಸನ್ಯಾಸಿ. That doesn't matter. There is a lifestyle. The lifestyle in which a person lives after giving up everything. Can you imagine that? So sannyasi means what? Is there a lifestyle? So a person who gives up everything, who gives up the family, who gives up all kinds of duties, who gives up the selfishness. So all things are given up. After giving up, there is a lifestyle. That lifestyle must be realized. Otherwise, what? You will lead yourself in wrong way. Because when Gita talks about the world, when it talks about the life, it brings the quality of the life. A sannyasi, a society which can protect a sannyasi. I mean, sannyasa is the great thing to adapt in one's life. Whether you married or not, you have to realize what is inner sannyasa and outer sannyasa. This inner sannyasa, by giving the karma phala up, you can feel it, you can own it. But this bahya sannyasa, you need to set up so many preliminary work. They have their own rules and regulations. Now you see, you are not going to become sannyasi means you need not to worry. Or if you want to become sannyasi means you will also gain the knowledge. But studying this chapter is very important, because this is set as the final goal, supreme goal of our Sanatana Dharma. Therefore, sannyasa is respected by our Shastra. Sannyasa is renounced by, and not only that, sannyasa is prized like anything. By saying this, I'm not suggesting you to become sannyasi. No. Sannyasa means to be understood. In the society, we have so many characters, but sannyasa, we also fix, it's also is a character. Because, let me say, sannyasa is not a field. It's not like a doctor, a lawyer, engineer, or a carpenter, or an artist. So this sannyasi is not one among them. Okay, the sannyasa is not understood. So there were we, the society is lacking. The sannyasa is the great thing. It is prized by all the scriptures. Doesn't matter you don't like or like the sannyasa, but you learn what is sannyasa. Sannyasa, it doesn't lie on this color. Sannyasa, it has its own glory. The glory doesn't depend on any outside sources. Therefore, Krishna, he began with inner sannyasa. So, inner sannyasa is the main core of the teaching. Okay, so now the Krishna answers, sannyasaha karma yogascha nishreyasa karau bhau. Both are valid, both have their own place, vital role in the society. Tayostu karma sannyasat karma yogo visheshyate. Now Krishna gives intelligent answer. He says, karma sannyasat karma yogaha visheshyate. Okay, this karma yoga is better than karma sannyasa. The karma yoga means what? Inner sannyasa, which was described in the fourth chapter. This inner sannyasa, so you cannot say the people that, do you know I have become inner sannyasi? You need not to say that. Once you could withdraw your karma phala from you, you are considered inner sannyasi. That inner sannyasa will bring the freedom inside. That freedom, you can see yourself from all the suffering. That itself is a great boon. But this outer sannyasa, it's not that it is not glorified. The outer sannyasa means karma sannyasa. It should take its own place. I mean, it has to take place automatically, like a fruit which is known as urvarukam. After being ripe, it separates itself from the tree. No pain, no suffering when it's separated. Like that, this karma sannyasa, it should take place its own. Automatically it will take place. You need not to make effort to get the karma sannyasa. Karma sannyasa means dropping all the duties. The duties, they have to drop themselves. Sannyasa will take place. Even, you know, people ask me, you know, when did you take sannyasa? How long have been taken sannyasa? That's not the way to ask. Sannyasa cannot be taken. Okay? Sannyasa means it's not to given up even. Sannyasa means which takes place its own. That's what the glory of sannyasa. You cannot give up anything, because giving up itself is sannyasa. So wrongly understood, most of the people understand. When you see the sannyasi, so some people become, you know, devotional. Some people become, you know, they may set aversion even. They may not like means they don't know what the inner understanding of the sannyasa must be. That you cannot gain the sannyasa. Sannyasa is not the state. Like moksha. Moksha is not the state. So sannyasa should take its own. And sannyasa means, what I mean to say, so sannyasa will take place. You cannot purposely get it. That's what Krishna means. This karma yoga, so you have to adapt in your life in order to get the self-growth. That self-growth, by dropping your karma phala, you will gain it. These all Advars and Nayanmars, they are jnanis, they are equal sannyasis. The sannyasa taken place in themselves. The next words, Nyayasa nitya sannyasi yo nadvesti nakankshati nirdvandvo hi mahabaho sukham bandhat pramuchyate. Now he describes who is real sannyasi, what is the definition for the sannyasa. Till he was talking about not sannyasa, he was talking about how to give up the karma phala, that's all. Now he has begun to talk about the terminology which is known as sannyasa, that we will understand. we must understand, because sannyasa is a special lifestyle. Nowhere it is given. Now we are confused how to deal with sannyasi, but sannyasis are aware. Sannyasa is, we have the rights, everybody has the rights to become sannyasi or to find inner sannyasa, so that we will also get a completeness. That completeness means what? Complete maturity. That maturity is called sannyasa, not denying anything. That we will understand from the next episode. Harihi Om. Om Purnamadah Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnamevavashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Harihi Om. Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Harihi Om. Oh.